Start Some Good. I'm a crowdfunding launch coach. And welcome back to the Crowdfunding 101 mini series. I hope you enjoyed that first video. Now, if you are watching this video anywhere other than inside the Crowdfunding 101 mini course, do sign up by the link below to make sure that you get all of the lessons and the accompanying worksheets, which is key to be able to turn these tips into relevant action for your campaign. All right, so to dive into lesson two, today we're going to be covering more of an overarching strategy for launching successful crowdfunding campaigns. And it's what we call our 5 C's launch strategy. So I'm going to talk you through it. You might want to take notes. If you haven't already, go ahead and download your worksheets so you can start to pen down some ideas and pathways and action items for your project to apply everything you're about to learn. Okay, so what are the 5 C's? Number one is clarity. It's absolutely imperative that you have clarity on your idea. And now this is not just the what you're doing, but why you're doing it. Very specifically, what are the tangible, measurable, physical indicators of your project? If you're looking at building a physical thing, show us the tools that you're using, show us a prototype, show us designs, sketches. The more specific and clear you can be, the better it's going to be for your donor to actually see in their mind's eye what it is you're creating. You can use images, whether it's photographs or drawings, to help your prospective donor really understand what it is you're doing. So not just using your words and your wonderfully descriptive language, but images always help as well. And then once you're clear on what you're doing, including times, dates, places, all those relevant who, what, where, when aspects of your campaign, but also the why. Tell us about your vision for a better world and help us see how these immediate tangible steps that you're taking with your project contribute to that bigger vision of a better world. Or if you're of the mind that you're starting with this bigger vision of the future that you're creating, make sure that you bring it down a few notches for us donors to see the tangible next steps that you're creating to enable that bigger vision to come about, because we need to be able to link the tangible to that big vision as well. So that's clarity in terms of your story. A couple of other areas where you're going to need crystal clear clarity is around your launch date. So when is the campaign starting? How long is the campaign running for, and when is it finishing? So getting really clear on your campaign timelines is super important. And we do recommend around a 25 to 35 day campaign. Any longer than that, you really risk losing momentum. Any shorter than that, and you might not have enough time to build up. So longer campaigns are not always better, particularly if you're a small team, because you do risk losing that momentum. And a final area where you need clarity is around your fundraising target. So how much are you raising, and what is it going to enable you to do? Remember to pin that fundraising goal back to the impacts and outcomes that you're going to create. Be really clear about how that first fundraising goal will enable you to take certain steps. And on Start Some Good, you can set that second fundraising target, your stretch goal. So again, just really clearly itemize what that stretch goal is going to enable you to do. Now, I will pop a link below here, and you'll hear a bit more about it in the coming videos about the specific strategies you want to use with setting your fundraising targets, because we do have a blended model on Start Some Good enabling you to set 2 goals, which we believe is what really enables our projects to have such a high success rate. So that's clarity. You can go ahead and download the worksheets related to clarity to help you brainstorm your project, get clear on your story, your campaign length, and your fundraising goals. So the second C of crowdfunding is credibility. Okay, because you need to be able to communicate with your audience why you and your team are the right people to be starting this project, and that you have the relevant skills, that you have the capacity and credibility to deliver on your promises. So there are five ways that you can signal credibility. Number one is your progress. So give us an indication of the progress that you've made on this project so far, because crowdfunding often, well, it almost always works best when you have progressed to a certain point. It's fairly unusual for people to fundraise an idea that is simply an idea and there's no progress that's been made. So maybe you've got some early relationships, you've got some sketches, you've even raised a little bit so far to get you to a certain point. Maybe you've got your team that you've pulled together. Give us an indication of the progress that you've made off your own steam, and then that makes a really compelling case for you to come to your audience of donors and say, hey, now we need your support to take this to the next level. So that's the first credibility P, it's progress. Second of all is partnerships. So I mentioned this before, that maybe there are organizations that you're partnering with or individuals who you're partnering with, which you can kind of leverage off their credibility. So maybe if you don't have a great track record of certain projects that are similar to the one you're launching, or awards or accolades or things that you can leverage, you could leverage your partner's credibility. Maybe they're a really established nonprofit, or maybe you've got a kind of ambassador you're working with who's got a big name. So leveraging your partnerships to signal credibility. The third P is people. So this is specific to your team. Maybe you've won some awards or accolades. Do list them in your campaign. I mean, you don't need to write your entire CV. Just really highlight those points that would give your donors confidence in you, and so that there is no argument for them internally that you are absolutely the right person to do this. The fourth P of credibility is your promises. So the promise that you're making to your donor community. Now, this is related to your fundraising model that you've chosen. So the all or nothing tipping point is by far the most credible fundraising model that you can use, because the promise that you're making to your donor is, I promise not to take your money unless I have enough other donors and contributions to hit that goal and deliver on my promises. Because if you've got a $10,000 goal and you only raise two, and you take that money but can't actually deliver on your project, that promise is, I'm going to take your money regardless of whether I reach my goal and regardless of whether I'll be able to deliver my project. It's not super credible. So, making sure that you communicate to your audience that you've chosen a tipping point which enables you to succeed only if you have that support, that critical mass of donations to enable you to deliver on your promises. Now, finally, the fifth P of credibility is your past. So this is more about your brand or historically other things, past projects that you've worked on that may be similar to the project you're delivering, or may be a way for you to indicate competencies or skills that relate to the project you're doing now. So that first P of credibility was progress, that's specific to your project. And the last P of credibility is your past, so other projects. Even if it was something you did 10 years ago, really leaning on your past. If you're an organization with a reputation, again, that past is really about your brand's reputation and credibility there as well. So just to quickly run through five P's of credibility, they are your progress, your partners, people, promises, and past. Moving on now to the third C of crowdfunding, communities. Not just any old communities, carefully chosen communities, because your goal is to convene, not convert. So you want to rally people who care about what you care about, who believe in the future that you're creating, and bring them together. So this is really all about your outreach strategy. And in the next lesson, actually, we're going to talk through the 5 story hooks that you can use to catch your community and get them engaged with your project. So we'll go into a bit more detail with using those story hooks. But for now, we're just going to move on to the 4th C, which is channels. So once you've identified who your communities are and you know which story hooks are going to engage and inspire them to donate, you then need to think about what channels you're going to be using to reach them. So an example of a channel: Facebook, email, WhatsApp, personal messages. And so with email, you know, even splitting it to database emails and personal emails. Another channel could be more of a broad media strategy, guest blogging, podcasts, reaching out to people in your network who have networks themselves. Maybe they've got a large email list or database where they could forward out your campaign, give it a spruik, message boards, Facebook groups, Twitter, Instagram. There are many, many channels to choose from. The key is in identifying the channels where your communities hang out and making sure that you have a consistent and compelling strategy on those channels. You don't necessarily need to use all of them. I'd recommend just picking a small number that feels manageable and being really consistent on the channels that you choose. Moving on to the 5th C of crowdfunding, it's courage. Because, friends, crowdfunding is not easy. 75% of campaigns fail. As you know, on Start Some Good, we have a much higher project success rate. 53% of campaigns on our site succeed. But that's not to say that it's not hard. I've personally run 4 campaigns myself. Every single one has succeeded. And in every single campaign, I hit the middle point, there was a lull in donations, and I had a crisis of confidence. And I know that campaign lulls are very, very typical. And there's a lot of donations at the beginning, a lot of donations at the end. And so it's about being able to hold your nerve and keep your head in the game and keep pushing, even when that fundraising thermometer starts to slow down a little bit. Stay courageous, believe in your idea, because that's ultimately what's going to enable you to get over the hump if there is a crisis in confidence, to keep pushing. And remember that your vision for a better world is not just about you. So get your ego out of the way and keep pushing for that change that you want to create. Plan for your outreach strategy and make sure that you have people in your corner, friends, mentors, crowdfunding coaches, to help you keep your head in the game and stay on top of it, even when things are looking a little bit, when you're getting a little bit nervous. Okay, so that's it, the 5 C's of crowdfunding. To run through real quick, we covered clarity, getting clear about your idea, your campaign length, and your fundraising goals. Credibility, leveraging credibility so that your audience knows you're the right people at the right time to be delivering this project. Communities, it's all about convening, not converting. Channels, make sure you use the channels that your community is using, and it's all about consistency, not necessarily about using all of them. And finally, courage, keeping your head in the game and staying committed to your vision for a better future. So that's it for today's lesson. Go ahead and download the worksheets, and I will see you in the next video, which is all about storytelling. And we're going to be going through those 5 storytelling hooks, which enable you to capture the attention, imagination, and passion of your community.